So, extraction. Let's review it.
Hey there, fellas. It's your boy Ashi again, and I actually just watched Netflix's new movie, Extraction, like about a week ago, and I gotta say, I'm pretty late on this review, but I will still consider doing so because the movie deserves all the praise that it can get, because it's actually a good movie. Let me just remind you, however, that this is gonna be a spoiler-filled review, because I already posted my spoiler-free review down on my Instagram, link down below if you want to see that instead, if you haven't seen the movie, that is. But if you're one of the people who have already seen the movie, well, stick to this review and let us discuss what makes this movie what it is today. So Extraction follows a black market mercenary named Tyler Wake, who is assigned to rescue and, guess what, extract this high-profile target basically out of Dhaka or Bangladesh. I'm not really sure on the locations on this one, although I still felt the culture within those locations. I'm just not really sure with the proper locations since I've never been to both places. So I hope that you bear with me on that one, but I'll try my best to describe everything that I loved about this movie. And I appreciate that they were able to show the culture of the place itself and the people that are in it, and I was actually feeling the whole thing. Because generally speaking, I don't watch a lot of Bollywood movies. I watch some of them, but for me, having this kind of balance between my usual thing and a Bollywood experience is actually a thing that I am grateful to have, so I actually commend it for this movie. And with that being said, I will keep moving on to the things that I liked about this movie. So basically, if I'm about to tell you the plot, yes, I know, it's the most bare-bones plot ever, and it could actually just work as a side arc for anyone in a series, but for this one, it becomes into a two-hour movie, which for me, it does not really hurt the movie that much, since the movie is titled Extraction, okay? It's not titled The Story of Tyler Wake or Tyler Wake, okay? This movie focuses more on the mission rather than on the person doing the mission, and that's what I like about it. Take for example comparing this to John Wick, and I know it gets compared a lot because both choreography and cinematography of both movies are like on the same standards for me, okay? It's my own opinion, but we'll get to that in a little while. If we try to consider the plot of both movies, we understand why John Wick focuses more on John Wick because it is titled such as, which needs to mainly focus on the character's arc and development throughout the movie or the franchise as it is. Compared to Extraction, which is titled as is, it really needs to focus more on what the mission is, although it was able to balance out with character development of not just the main character but also some of the characters, but it's not really that much. But it was enough for you to sympathize with every one of them. For me, however, what sets this movie a more favorable one than John Wick Chapter 3, this is just my own opinion, okay, is for the fact that every time I watch John Wick Chapter 3, and I've always had this as a stand for me, I always felt that that movie was more focused on the world building rather than on the war itself. I mean, you name yourself John Wick 3 Parabellum and not feature a whole war within the movie and like set up for a war for the next movie, which is kind of a bummer whenever I rewatch that movie itself. And I really felt that John Wick 3 was more style and less substance. I mean, it's not style, no substance, but style and less substance. I still like the movie, but it's never as good as the first movie or even the second one. And for me, Extraction is actually a better John Wick 3 Parabellum because it has the logic, it has the action, and it also has the focus. And I think that's what I really loved about this movie. So yeah, for me, it's really a plus that they were able to pull it off even though they only had the most bare bones of plot. Especially that I can remember one movie that has the same premise as this one titled Mile 22, which flop harder than this movie. Believe it or not, action movies like this come and go like since before. They do exist since before because it's not really an original story. But in terms of these kind of movies, what needs to be done in order for them to stand out among each other is the execution. And for me, this is the well-executed version of that story in most recent years, to be honest, okay? And as I said before, the choreography and the cinematography, I will just put them in one category because they're both top-notch, okay? The trailer for this movie does not really do justice on how good this movie is because the trailer seemed like your typical action movie, and what's worse is that I actually made a regard that this movie felt like an early 2000s action movie, which I was okay, by the way, but at the same time, you really do need to innovate of the standards of today, which is one of the reasons why a few days before this movie came out, my expectations weren't that high. But when I finished watching this movie,
goddamn, what a rush!
Woo! I gotta say, every action scene in this movie feels something out of, well, mainly John Wick and The Raid, and a small touch of Jason Bourne in it, okay? Or the Bourne franchise, actually. So basically what I'm trying to say here is it successfully blends the different styles of action that we have known before and put it together in one film, and at the same time not look as if it was forced to blend all three action styles together to make something unique out of this movie. I tell you, if you have watched all three movies that I've mentioned and you watch this, you'll definitely get what I mean. And that Warner scene, that was actually kind of awesome. Now you might be thinking, is this movie just good because of the action? I'm gonna say no, okay? It was still able to do some character developments within the movie, that it is enough for you to care about every single character that this movie had. Chris Hemsworth, always a likable dude in any movie that he's in. I even watched Red Dawn and he's like the most likable character in that movie, okay? Too bad the movie was shit. In this movie, you still do get to understand his motivations, although it's not that deep. It's just a means to his end. But throughout the movie, it changes because of the synergy that Tyler and Ovi displays on screen. And I really loved it because they really felt like father and son. And I like the fact that they all have different motivations as to why that developed as well. Like I said before, Tyler Rake's motivations are very shallow at first. It's all about the money, just means for an end. If he dies, he dies. And in the middle of the movie, we learn that Tyler was a father. I emphasize on the was there. And he lost his chance to continue being a father when his son died. Ovi, on the other hand, we learn that this character is being looked upon by his own father as nothing but an object. And Ovi as well can't think of anything about his father because every single day that he sees his father, what he sees is a killer. So initially, this was just a mission for them, but later on, they realize this is actually an opportunity for both of them to make up what's lacking in their lives. And I really love that dynamic, that at the end, I really did cry so hard. And also, one more thing that made me cry is the character of Saju, which was played perfectly by Randy Pooda. I am intrigued in watching more movies from him because of how good he was. And funny thing, I actually rooted for this guy more than Tyler Rake. His motivations were quite simple. He's doing it because he knows Ovi. He treats Ovi as his own son and as well as to save his own family. One more character that I would want to commend is Nick. Initially, the character of Nick never appealed to me, okay? I just saw her on screen and she was like, there. And as it progressed through until the third act, which is on the third act, by the way, is where I've seen her badass side. And I actually love her character. I would not have a problem if they make another movie based on this universe and would have her as the main protagonist for that movie. I really wouldn't have any problems with that because I feel that she can actually carry her own movie in this universe. There are still flaws in this movie, one of which is the antagonist. I actually like the antagonist because his entrance makes it feel like he's really this dude that would not stop at anything to get what he wants. His entrance was like really fucked up. I mean, it's not gory, but you know, it sticks in your brain for quite too long. But as the movie progressed, his presence was kind of faltering as well until the last act where he was just like looking through a binoculars as to what's going on, like he's pay-per-viewing that shit. And then his arc ends and that's just that. And I was really disappointed of how underused he was, because he was really convincing on being like this standalone bad guy, even though we don't know him basically. He was really good in carrying the role, and I really wish that they didn't just end his arc immediately. It could have been another story for another day, but sadly by the end. Also, one other character that kind of disappointed me was the character of David Harbour. I had problems with it since I've seen an ad, well, a picture from Netflix, and it states there that this is a David Harbour you have never seen before, and I'm like, oh, that's so intriguing. But when I finally watched the film,
no,
I mean, it's just a simple role that any actor could have played. But this next problem that I have is something that stuck in my head from beginning to end of this movie, and it's the color grading. A good color grading can be the difference of a great movie, an average movie, and a bad movie. I didn't really feel the color grading of this movie. There's a reason why I still prefer Captain America Winter Soldier than Captain America Civil War. I personally thought that the color grading that they used in both movies fit more for the themes of Captain America the Winter Soldier. Captain America Civil War did not fit the color grading that they had. Captain America Civil War was kind of like, in terms of plot, it was really good, but the color grading really ruins it for me. I mean, it's not a really big thing, but it is still a thing, and if it's done in an extensive kind of way, it really becomes a problem. I really didn't like the yellow color grading of this movie because it kind of generalizes the whole location thing of how this country always has to look like this. You can watch all movies that involve Mexico and you would find the fact that they almost have the same color grading in every single movie that features Mexico. I see what they're doing here, and it's kind of like the same thing with that, and I really didn't like it. I mean, I see pictures in IMDb and they look a lot better in the normal color grade. I hope Sam Hargrave fixes his choices for color grading next time, but I don't really think that's a major problem for him. I mean, this is still his directorial debut and things can still improve for the guy. So all in all, even though this movie had flaws for me, I don't really think them as too much to bring this movie down. I still really love this movie, okay? I know it's divisive among people right now and I understand where you guys are coming from, but a review is a review and my opinion is only my opinion. You can agree with it, you can not agree with it, it depends upon you. But yeah, for the fact alone that this movie is an easy binge, it has likable characters, talented performances from both foreign and Hollywood, awesome cinematography and choreography, and for the fact that you only have to watch it in the comfort of your own home, this movie is a package deal for you. And this movie is one that I'll rewatch till I die. Or basically an 8.5 out of 10. Yes, I know in my written review it was an 8 out of 10, but it's another explanation for another day, and I kind of cranked it up because I watched it for the third time now and I still love it until this day. But Red Dawn though, his death in that movie was really unexpected, I tell you. Anyway, Extraction, what did you think about the movie? Whatever it is, whatever you think, comment it down below and let me know. And also, if you like this video, click the like button down below and also share it with your friends so that it will go a long way. Liking and sharing are the only ways for now to produce more exposure for my channel and for my videos. And if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing because I will be putting up more videos soon enough. So yeah, once again, Oshie out.